Oh, all right. I just started recording the game footage.
All
Where's Flip?
I'm here.
Oh, shit.
I heard Flip say nothing.
What game footage are you talking about, buddy?
Well, Flip, I'm glad you asked.
Yeah, we're trying a new thing where we're all playing Hardline while we podcast. And we're going to put it on YouTube with our podcast over the footage.
No, all right.
That way we have a new outlet for the show.
Just special, isn't it?
Vampire Mob told us to put it on YouTube.
I trust dude's name Vampire.
I think putting shit on YouTube's a good idea.
They know what's up. They suck blood. Oh Lord, damn! I just spawned into a fucking RPG. Jesus Christ.
This is gonna be great.
Ready to start the show?
Always.
Oh, there's a show?
There's a show.
Good thing you're hosting.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah, I'm not.
Alright, welcome to the Stonewall Jackson 5. I'm ZP. We've got Kaiser.
What's up?
Flip.
Yo.
Cable.
Leave me alone, I'm biting.
You're baiting?
Yeah, and hot wire.
So anyway, fuck table. Fuck Kaiser and Flip.
Hey, bud.
How's everybody's nights going?
Well, it's pretty game free for me over here, but what's going
You're
on with you
You're not playing
guys?
Fire Emblem on your DS?
Oh, what? Shit, let me do that.
Yeah, man.
You're a fucking genius, ZP. I don't care what Tubby says about you at the gym.
ZP does come up a lot in workouts.
I'm just glad that he's thinking of me when he's, you know,
coming.
Lifting them weights.
Hell yeah. Grunting away on that booty.
On Flip's booty.
Nah, bruh.
I write ZP on it, though.
Oh! Now, nah, boy. Boy, none of that.
Some of that. I mean, I'm feeling nice. I like hearing that.
Okay, well, all of it for you, bud. You can have it all. Oh, shit, wonderful. There's a fucking ass load of fucking topics in here. Who the fuck has been productive?
Yeah, ZP came prepared. He's like,
ZP
I'm
is tired.
We're going to play video games, but we're going to have a shitload of time.
I figured it looked pretty bare, so I'd clean it up and make it look nice and add some bullshit.
Nice. It does pretty be in charge of this for all time.
The True Detective, we're three episodes into the season. Have you guys been keeping up with it, or what?
I haven't watched the last two yet.
I watched the third one. Yeah, I never did get to watch it again. Like,
yeah,
legit watch.
Because I'm going to watch them like two or three in a row. I'm going to watch them probably on Sunday. I don't have anything to do Sunday.
Yeah, I definitely need to rewatch the third one because I was only giving it half my attention, but
I want to say that I paid 100% attention to the third one as well, but I did not. I remember certain parts, like rubber bullets and like gold teeth getting removed, but
that fat dude tried to fight him and lost.
That fight should have been fat dude all the way. Why didn't he do the typical fat man attack and just fucking try to tackle Vince Vaughn in that small ass room? He's
right.
An idiot. He deserved to get his ass beat.
Yeah, man, you talking to the choir there, man. I'd have fattied him for sure.
Had to. He was a bum.
You're underestimating Vince Vaughn. I mean, Wiley, that Vince Vaughn.
He's a big dude, man.
Yeah,
he played for Notre Dame and Rudy, so.
Yes, he did.
Son, he was in Rudy?
Yeah.
Really?
Him and Favreau were both in Rudy.
That's where they fell in love.
That is where they
Probably
fell in love.
Exactly where it was in the shower.
Fuck!
Whoa, guys.
Oh, damn, I got sabotaged.
Oh, you guys are going to make me eventually get an X-Bone. Just do this kind
of
stuff.
You can just put it on as expense for the show.
Yeah, okay.
It's for the show.
Why don't you buy it for me and write it off as an expense?
This game's so fucking fun, man. I love this fucking mode.
No, if you buy it for him, you could write it off as charity.
There you go. I'll take that.
Put it there with like the bags of clothes you drop off at Goodwill.
Damn. I wouldn't consider Flip Goodwill, but okay.
You can consider me what you want if you buy me a free system.
Disabled American veterans, whatever you want to do.
Oh, my goodness.
But, yeah.
So, yeah, I've watched the first three episodes, but the third one I need to rewatch. And I've been rewatching the first season. I'm four episodes deep in that.
Is it still as delightful as...
It definitely is. I still like season two so far, but everyone's so fucking grim in season two compared to season one.
Right. There's no Marty Hart, man.
Right, yeah. Woody's not there to bring some levity. I mean, even Rust.
Yeah.
Wasn't they plagiarized. Complete...
Yeah, Rust is just a cynical guy, but he's not like a grim face.
Everyone's like mugging everybody in that fucking season two, except for like, well, the main characters are the ancillary. Larry characters, fucking the mayor, and
he's all Batman.
Yeah, it's they are. They're all Christian Bale Batman.
Yeah,
well, yeah.
Give it in taste.
Yeah, Woody brought a little humor to the show.
A little shit.
A lot. Yeah. That fucking
got out a finger in the ass.
Yo. But look, you can't compare the brilliance of the first one to this one. That's what some fucker with a beard told me. And
you can't.
I mean, but you do. You can't not, because you fucking. Yeah. It's True Detective, bruh. Like, go ahead.
No, go ahead. Finish your statement.
I was just gonna say the only thing that might even be possibly comparable is like the intro song. I kind of like this fucking season two one a little bit better. But nothing else.
Comparing them to each other is tough. Yeah. Not comparing them is tough, but like in season two, it's just when you're watching the first season again concurrent with it, it makes things like, man, this one's such a downer compared to the first one's got, you know, all the weird sex cult shit too and all the implied things, and it's not like the main characters are perfect there. But it's so blatant how different they are.
Right.
As far as tone, but they're still both good shows.
Get in, ZP.
Yeah, it's good, but yeah, they
should have kept it at two.
Side by side, yeah, it's hard to give season two any slack right now.
I don't even have to watch. I don't have to watch season one ever again. And 10 years from now, I'll still know that it's better than season two.
All right.
Like, unless season two just has the most amazing.
They just
fucking...
They went so fucking hard on the first season, dude. They're like, they'll never be able to fucking.
They'll never top it. They fucking exactly. Have to know. It'll probably get canceled after this
I remember thinking when the first season was out and I was watching it, I watched it all like on a free HBO weekend, so I watched it all back to back to back.
Yeah.
Marathon that shit. And I remember thinking, you know, some shit got pretty dark and fucked up, but I'm watching season two and one together now, and one's like all. Almost lighthearted and old school compared to season two, where everyone's fuck this, fuck that, fuck everything, and like beating the shit out of some 12-year-old's dad on his lawn and gonna, you know, fuck him with his headless corpse of his wife or some shit. And in the season one, like the roughest it got in the first three episodes is Rust is beating a guy with a toolbox.
You only see it for like 2 seconds at that.
Yeah, there's not a whole bunch of blood. There's not. It's just it's weird how different they are, but they're coming from the same guy. Of course, there's different directors.
Yeah,
they took a big hit with that alone.
I don't know. I'm placing this on the writer right now because.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's everything. I mean, it's the actors. It's the fucking setting. Of course, it's the writer / creator. Fucking.
But Rust Cole is just such a fucking good character.
It's not you keep mentioning Rust. It's the Rust and fucking Marty dynamic
combo. Yeah.
That just cannot be matched.
Right,
nobody is friends with anybody in this fucking.
And there
show.
Is no dynamic yet. That's exactly.
Everybody's
right.
Like trying to play each other a little bit and shit. And it's like the fucking interaction between all the cops and their superiors throws it off a little bit because they're all giving them different fucking missions within the fucking operation.
Yeah, you're supposed to be looking out for this guy, and you're supposed to be looking out for this guy.
You know,
they want to dig dirt up on each other.
Fucking gay, you know what I'm saying? It's like, well, that's cool, but does that really add a layer of character to his character? No.
I mean, things happen in the desert, and they evolved male asses.
Dog, I mean, he can do what he got to do, dog. I'm just saying.
That's what happened.
Be interesting when you're doing it.
I was drunk half watching it while I was playing Dark Souls 2. Sins of the First
Dark
Scholar.
Dark Souls 2 was a much better use of your time.
Yeah, and I was like, aww. I looked over and I was like, wait a minute, is he turning out gay?
No, you didn't see that, man, in like the first fucking episode?
I mean, that's what I was thinking, because no, he had to pop pills to smash that incredibly hot Latino woman.
You know, yeah, I didn't see it in the first episode, to be fair, but in the second episode when they're like making a focus of the two, you know, underwear angel guys, and
just, I don't even remember that.
CP does.
Because we're doing the episode 2 and 3 recap right now, because we didn't recap episode 2. I thought episode 2 was great. I remember thinking that and saying that in the thing, but
he has his story to dude from Deadwood about how he's going to beat the guy. He's looking for information. Then, like, later on in the episode, looking out his balcony or wherever he's at. Yeah, there's some chicks, and then the camera lingers on the two guys dressed as, like, angels in their underwear. From, like, Kitch's point of view.
Yep, don't even remember.
That's why I need to rewatch episode 3 so I can pick up more of that shit.
ZP kept pausing it on that part.
I didn't have to keep pausing. You pause once, you get the screen grab, and you're done. I don't fuck,
I don't fuck around, boy. Yeah, I mean, I'm still, because episode 2 was actually really good, so I'm just hoping 3 was another one of those.
They should have let Colin Farrell die, dog, or be fucking. Not because I hate Colin Farrell or anything, just like if he would have been murked, that would have been amazing.
Yeah, it feels like a bit of a cop out.
Yeah, it would have been incredible. Like, he looked like he got destroyed. He should have just fucking been dead, and that would have been some, oh shit, now, you know, this is. You know, this is kind of approaching season 1 levels. If
on
you got
the one
some
hand,
amazing shit like that.
On the one hand, I'm glad he's alive because he was honestly my favorite character. You know, it was close with him and Vince Vaughn, but nudged him out. But on the other hand, yeah, it felt like a complete cop-out to go there.
Yeah.
And then, it's okay.
Yeah, right.
I had a Twin Peaks dream and now I'm all right.
It's like, but did he get... He got knocked out from getting hit in the stomach or the chest with the fucking... rubber bullets?
Yeah, I guess the second shot in the gut, I guess, knocked him out. The pain or whatever.
Yes.
I picked the wrong class, Kaiser. Heal me.
You know what it is?
Heal me.
Did a second person get killed in this episode? Or is it still... Are they still trying to solve the murder of...
It's still Casper that they're trying to solve, but...
See, that's another thing, man. Like, it's like...
From kids?
Oh, he died by nature.
Kaiser, heal me.
But I don't know, man. I don't know. Wait, what are y'all playing?
Battlefield? Oh, God.
Yeah, Hardline.
Battlefield Hardline.
Yeah.
Such a fucking good game.
Kaiser refusing to heal my car. I died.
Was Kaiser a mechanic in that world, not a shooter?
Yeah, we're all mechanics in Hotwire. Because all you do is drive around cars, like, and you get points by just keeping them on the road.
Oh, fucking John's in.
John's in here? Oh, yeah. You're going to be like, why is nobody talking? Hi, John. When you listen to this episode later, because I know you love the Stonewall Jackson 5, you'll know why.
Well, who doesn't love the Stonewall Jackson 5?
Exactly.
Yeah, the overarching plot so far seems to be that Casper's dead. He's a city manager who ripped off Vince Vaughn. There's three different police assigned to solve the crime. Really, the state highway patrol and then the county, I think McAdams is county or some shit.
I think it's like two different, because she's
LA about, county.
Right.
Yeah, she's county, and then
Vinci.
Yeah, he's state, and then, well, yeah, Colin Farrell's Vinci, he's city, she's county, and then Kitch is like state highway patrol.
Yeah.
Right.
And the county and the patrol are both supposed to be looking out to find how fucked up the city is, get as much dirt as they can. Colin Farrell is supposed to be covering
Irish.
That shit up. Yes, he's supposed to be Irish. That's why he drinks a lot.
He fucking wants to stay angry.
He switches the water because he wants to stay mad.
What the fuck, son? Come on. I get so much angrier when I'm drunk.
I get drunk. I'm going to forget how pissed off I am about getting shot.
Oh, Colin. Yeah, I don't know. This has got to pick up soon enough. Like, I'm going to just watch it mainly for the sake of this show. But I need to start enjoying it soon.
I'd continue watching it even if I didn't know you people.
Right.
I don't know if I would. I like Vince Vaughn beating people up, but he didn't go home and smash his wife. I was mad at that. It's like, son, she's right there. Got her, you know, the lingerie that she's been hiding in the closet for 20 years waiting to break it out. And he didn't take advantage, bro. I was like, Vince, you disappoint me now. Disappoint me.
Ooh, snub nose.
I that guess that's about as far as we're going to get with True Detective until season 4. Not season 4, episode 4. Season 4. It's only supposed to be 3 seasons, so I don't think we're going to make it to season 4.
Well, I'm telling you, there might not be a fucking third. Fucking, I don't know what the ratings have been, though.
I just want to see who they cast for season 3.
Patty Considine would be fucking great on True Detective. That was a great call.
Yeah, he would.
Wait, who is it?
Patty Considine.
I don't think I know who that is.
He's a dude from the UK.
He's in all the fucking like Simon Pegg and Nick Cross movies.
Amazing. Okay.
He did Dead Man's Shoes, Tyrannosaurus.
Nah, but I'll take y'all's word for it.
He's wonderful.
He is wonderful.
Alright, so yeah, we've exhausted True Detective, I guess, with our in-depth analysis.
Mm-hmm. What is? Let's see.
We've got.
Tell us about Arnie.
Well, Arnie, I was just thinking we could talk about him in general.
Oh. The Governator.
Because you know he's has the new shitty Terminator that came out. I haven't seen it.
Have you seen my movie?
It's terrible. As we all know.
I don't think I've seen this guy at all.
I haven't seen it.
Is it really that bad? You saw it already?
No, I haven't seen it, but it just looks horrible, and from what I've read, it lives up to the way it looks. You know, and
trying to say Arnold doesn't have the blood of the dragon?
Now, Arnold typically is great, and even the reviews are saying he's still Arnold, he's still got it, but the movie just sucks, everything without him. And that's the way it's been for a number of his movies since the 90s. You know, even Arnold himself, though, he's great at self-promoting and talking about how great his shit is. But, like, you know, a few months ago, he was talking about how, yep, they're going to film the sequel in the later this year, within the next year, and his plans for the trilogy. And then, like, a couple weeks ago, he was all backpedaling on that and said, hey, talks of a sequel might be presumptuous. We need to see if the, you know, have this one released, make it sure it's good, and see if the audience watch it and like it. So, like, I think he saw a cut of it after the, you know, after post and said, no, fuck.
Oh, I think no,
even he realized.
Yes.
He's like, it's not my movie.
And that's the way it's been with most of his movies.
I didn't do it.
That's pretty good.
What is he?
Since he banged the man, stop being governor.
Tell him.
That's fucking great.
Yeah. I bet he misses California now.
Yeah, how much is it now? Come on.
But South Arnold, we start losing.
Alright, so...
I guess nobody wants to talk about Arnold.
I'm totally good with that. Y'all are fucking focused on Hardline for 2 seconds.
I'm not. I'm trying to talk about Arnold.
I know, but let's talk about Arnold.
We gotta worry about Michael Biff.
So why... So, first off, let me ask y'all...
Hey, this is all about the objectives.
Oh, shit. Alright, but let me ask y'all first.
My ratio is sinking.
Do you guys agree that, fucking Salvation was trash at all?
It was much better than 3.
I'm about to say, I liked it. I liked Salvation a lot.
Was that, that was the
I'm
Bell
just
one?
A Terminator fanboy. There's none that I hate.
That's the Bell.
Yeah, that was the Bell one. It wasn't as good as the first two, yeah. But
of course
I still
not,
liked it.
Of course
yeah.
not. It was
I even liked 3, though. I mean...
I did not like 3 at all.
I didn't think I was going to like 3 from what I saw of that movie, so I never watched it still.
Didn't that girl get Nike?
Like, the biggest disappointment for me was... When the beginning of the movie and John Connor of Salvation, at least number 4, when John Connor crawls out of the fucking hole that he was in, and you just see Terry Crews' corpse, like he wasn't even in the movie, like they cut all of his scenes where he was alive, so you only see him dead.
What the fuck?
I mean, that's a loss. Terry Crews kind of adds.
Terry Crews is great.
Yeah, he's amazing.
One of the best parts of all the Expendables movies.
He'll be the new Terminator.
Oh, that'd be amazing. I would go to everyone then.
But yeah, overall, I liked it.
It's black.
I actually named my iPod after his character in Expendables. I got a big black iPod with one of the old school ones, but like with a huge hard drive, and I named it Hail Caesar after Terry Crews because it was big and black.
That's as good a reason as any to name something.
But yeah, Arnold, you know, talking about how he wasn't in the fourth one, he says, "Well, thank God that one sucked." But as he was talking up how the original trilogy was so good and there's only three until this new Genesis, it's like, really, Arnold? That's that self-promotion shit that, I mean, people do, but...
Yeah, but Arnold, come on. Terminator is still, like, you know, you're fucking associated with all the films. Your fucking CG double was in goddamn...
Yeah, he had his head in there. Yeah,
and I'm sure he had to, like, approve that, so...
He got paid. I mean,
yeah. Why would you shit on that joint?
He was talking about the Predator movies recently, within the last few days.
Oh man, he can't say that fucking 2 and Predators suck.
Yeah, he said that, you know, none of them after the first one have lived up to the first one. It's like, well, yeah, you can't reach those heights. But I liked Predator 2. I liked the Predators to an extent. It had some problems, like with the super predator nonsense, but other than that, I really did like Predators.
You like the one with Adrian Brody's bitch ass?
Yeah, I did.
I like that one too. I mean,
did you see Walton Goggins?
I never saw that movie because Adrian Brody was supposed to be a badass, and I was like, fuck that shit. I'll never watch
it. He's kind of believable as a badass, but yeah, Walton Goggins is in it. The dude that plays Remy from House of Cards is in it. Fucking
Larry Fishburne.
Yes, Cowboy Curtis himself, bro.
The problem, though, with the biggest problem with Predators was the same problem that lots of these sequels to Arnie movies have, is they just try so hard to fucking reference original shit.
Yeah.
There's Get to the Chopper again. There's fucking... Oh, there's not. I lied. But there's... but there are a number of references. Oh, yeah, the... Lawrence Fishburne is, like, mimicking... the over here shit from the first movie, and Adrian Brody finds out that mud is camouflage, and he douses himself, covers himself in mud.
Wow, so they relived everything and made Adrian Brody to Arnold scene. Fuck that shit.
No, not even. Just watch the fucking movie.
Tony. Nope.
It's... Nope.
D-Man, C, fucking ZP.
I mean, Adrian Brody doesn't know shit about mud.
And then there's, like, somebody else that's, like, supposed to be badass that's fucking retarded as well. It's not Michelle Rodriguez. Who else?
Nah.
Well, there's
Topher Grace is in it.
He's in it.
That's probably the one.
Does he play Jesse Ventura?
Yeah, right?
That would be amazing.
Is he the Indian guy? He's, like, yells on the bridge.
Oh, don't ever forget
Billy!
Is he Billy?
Nah, he's not. He's not.
It's
Sonny
unfortunate
Landis.
That nobody is Carl Weathers, though.
Fucking, oh man, that's fucking hilarious.
I watched a lot of Carl Weathers shit over the fucking 4th of July week, and they had like a Rocky marathon on, so I caught 2, 3, and 4.
Mm-hmm.
Then the next day I was watching Predator.
That was a good time. That was a good time.
Kind of like Carl Weathers.
Dude, Carl Weathers is awesome.
No Happy Gilmore, though? To finish it off?
No, right? I didn't watch Happy Gilmore.
Oh, you fucked up.
I fucked up.
Yeah, you didn't watch that.
I think that, you know, those movies probably kind of have to pay homage just a little bit. I mean,
I think they'd go a lot further if they didn't.
I mean, I don't think that they have to do as much as they do, but I mean, you want to give little winks to that shit. I mean, Predators was like a 12, 13 year gap or some shit from Predator 2 or something like that. Like, it was a ridiculous amount of time in between. So, you know, it's a new generation of motherfuckers watching that shit.
Well, and compared to the fucking Alien versus Predator movies,
it
was amazing.
Oh my god, that shit, right, it was a masterpiece. So, I don't know.
I will never watch that Adrian Brody one.
No, you're just the fucking suck up.
I've never...
Table, I won't watch it. I won't watch it either.
Hell yeah, I'll fucking heal your car.
Heal the car. Damn.
Kaiser, Kaiser is like Biff at the end of Back to the Future. He's like, "Let me wax your car for you, sir."
Oh, Tubby McFly.
Fucking hate you, ZP.
All right, Kaiser, you can watch the fucking Adrian Brody Predators. It's got Walton Goggins.
It sounds fucking retarded, though. Like,
it's not. It's really not as bad as I guess I accidentally made it sound.
I was about to say, you kind of like fucking...
I don't like the call. I don't like the constant callbacks. It's like, yes, I get it. I've seen the other movies. I like the other movies. Do your own thing. Don't need Lawrence Fishburne hiding in the jungle going, over here.
See, Lawrence Fishburne can be Carl Weathers. Why didn't they fucking do that then?
So just like Carl, I mean, Lawrence Fishburne was dope in that movie. Even if he said the over here shit, I mean, everything else about him was pretty great.
I don't know. That kind of fan service just makes me roll my eyes.
Yeah. I don't know.
But I'm a picky bastard.
He was okay.
But so there's going to be a sequel to Genesis? Or, you know, there's going to be
there,
six?
There was. But considering this one bombed like crazy.
Arnie's like, no.
Okay, I'm looking at the quote now.
They're eventually going to make another one because fucking
money.
No, it can't. What money? If it's bombing, it's not making any money.
They'll make money internationally because they, you know, hired the South Korean guy, so all the Asian people will see it in Asia. And they'll make money off of video.
I hope if Shane Black does another one, this one will be great.
No, that Shane Black one was like announced like a year and a half, 2 years ago. So there's been like no movement that I've heard of since.
Yeah, but I mean, I kind of wanted to continue the Predators storyline where they're stuck on that planet. But if not, then what are they going to do? I don't want a reboot of like the original with new motherfuckers in the jungle.
I actually think that shit could kind of work. Similar to what the Thing prequel tried to do, if they deal with Hopper's men.
The Thing prequel
was
all right.
The first dudes. I was fine with it. Yeah. But if they dealt with like that crew that Arnie was going in there because they fucking disappeared, they dealt with those.
Right. The dudes that got flayed and fucking hung up.
Adrian Brody
gets
Brandon Lee on set, I'll watch it.
Said what?
Holy shit.
I said if Adrian Brody gets Brandon Lee on set, I'll watch it.
Poor Brandon Lee.
Don't disrespect the son because you hate the father, bro.
No, I love the son. That's what I'm saying. I hate that something happened to him, but I'm saying if that happened to Adrian Brody, I would watch that movie. No, I love Brandon Lee.
Fucking show when you were talking about Showdown in Little Tokyo, dude. Fucking, I haven't seen that shit in fucking years.
I had the desire to watch it again, and I'm glad I did.
Fucking Dolph Lundgren and fucking Brandon Lee, and Brandon Lee is just fucking whooping ass and shit.
Well, Dolph Lundgren's the fucking wannabe weeaboo samurai guy, and Brandon Lee's just Brandon Lee's the goofy American yuppie. it's really funny.
And he actually has Asian in him.
Right.
Explain the way.
Brandon Lee could have gone places had he not been Brandon Lee on this set of The Crow.
Son, R.I.P. Y'all gotta chill, man.
Damn.
I just want to know if Tubby's cosplay was worth the death of a great American.
No, man.
Oh, Tubby.
Great American died so Tubby could, you know, pretend he was a goth kid for a few nights.
I mean, I've dressed up as the Crow like probably six Halloweens.
Wow.
But you're so big, you fucking... You just
it's a big-ass fucking Crow is what I always
you just look like Sting.
Yeah, like some people used to like, is that Sting? Like, fuck you. I mean, don't get me wrong. I used to watch wrestling WWE just because Sting looked somewhat like the Crow. That's how much I love the Crow.
Oh, that's sad.
Well, that's like the fucking like the 64 fucking wrestling game. Remember, you could fucking play with Sting and shit.
Yeah, I pretty much turned it off
Revenge.
The whole time.
Yeah, of course. He comes in with the bat.
Yep.
Don't get me started on those fucking Nintendo 64 wrestling games.
Dude, man. What was that? Like Kai or Tokai, whoever made those, were fucking...
I think
the creative like character, you can make ninjas Akai, and shit.
Yeah, yeah. No,
I want a I want a wrestling game for the PlayStation off of like a soda bottle cap in the 90s.
Sorry.
And that's all I did was to create a character. I spent so much time doing that shit.
Was it from a surge?
It was. I was at the hospital. So like my brother was there. I hit the machine and I wanted one thing and it gave me a surge and I was pissed off. I didn't want a fucking surge. And then I, under the cap, I won a video game. So it worked out.
That's what, did you go ape shit or were you like, oh, okay, a video game?
Oh, I don't, I'm not one of those guys who starts going like over super excited and shit and jumping up and down.
But how old were you at this
time? Like, you were never I would have been in like middle school.
I was five, open Christmas presents, like whatever, mom.
Middle school or middle school or high school.
Thanks, mom, geez,
this is the worst Hanukkah ever.
All right.
It's okay. Oh,
I don't like jump up and down like a fucking retard. I don't.
But he goes to punk shows and like fuck the mosh pit.
I mean, I would, you know, it would feel forced and unnatural, and it'd be insulting to the other people if I faked it.
Why would you have to fake it? Jesus, I mosh at a country show. What the fuck?
I'm talking about like getting excited over winning a fucking video game.
No, because you love video games, don't you? Even if it was Fable, would you have not been in?
Man, my receiver at McDonald's says I get a free McFlurry. I fucking shit my pants.
I
don't get free shit a lot, so.
I won a $500 right? gift card
What's
to
the
Jew
power
Walmart
you guys
in high school, and I like, it was great. I was happy, but I'm not going to go, oh my God, I won. I'm not going to be like that fucking
no, but I mean,
dick on the TV wins the lottery. Here's my publisher clearinghouse check.
Well, I won a million.
That's why you don't ever win shit, because they know you wouldn't even give them what they wanted.
Don't turn
around. Oh, shit. A homo died. God, I'm sucking some shit.
I mean, if people want to, like, give me free shit, we'll find out if my outlook changes. But it'd have to be pretty impressive free shit, I guess.
Like a fleshlight?
Like, if I win a car, like, with a built-in fleshlight, I still don't think I'd flip out.
It's
nice,
just impossible
but
to please, bro. What the fuck?
I'm doing people a favor by not being fake with them.
Is that what it is that you're doing?
I'm doing a public service. Like, everyone's used to all this bullshit. Oh my God, my life has changed.
I mean, no, it don't have to. I mean, if you get a free car, it did change.
Yeah, people get excited. Shit, man, what the fuck? You talk about people. Win. You talk about people not getting excited over video games. You over here like, I want some shit, man. Fuck it.
Yeah,
no. I mean, this is nice, thank you, but I'm not gonna fucking cry for you.
You ain't no Argentina. I ain't crying.
I think, yeah. I mean, if I won like a fucking $1 million, I'd be pretty fucking excited.
I'd be excited, but I mean, keep your shit together. Act like you've been there. Act like you've been there before.
But you've never been there before.
I mean, you can still act like it.
Nah, man. For what?
Act like you've been there. Yeah, that's $1 million. Act like you've been there.
Ghost
ain't nothing new.
Fuck no, bro.
Don't get on the roof and scream about it, boy.
Oh no, not the roof. Oh,
what's wrong with the roof?
I don't even know what that is.
All right, do you say foot or foot?
Foot.
A foot.
We well,
then fuck you, roof.
Yeah, I don't think that's how that shit works. But
so, Kaiser, you linked something about Netflix original movies? Would you like to expound upon that subject?
I feel like you skipped something. Skip real quick. Are you going to skip over
the sounds of the topic police?
I think we're going to go back. We always jump topics now.
I don't know. I feel like we jumped really quickly when we were on the subject of the roof. I don't
that is a...
Did your dog say roof or roof?
Speaking of roofs.
Netflix has movies about roofs.
Oh, boy.
I mean, fuck. You want to talk about like the beasts of... What was the name of the fucking... Fukunaga movie with what's his nuts, Idris Elba. Beast of No Nation.
I don't know what
that is.
Yeah,
was that good?
No, it's not out yet.
Oh. I was thinking about Beast of Southern Wild, which I saw.
That's the one where, like, they taped stuff to pigs and made them be monsters?
Really?
Isn't that the one, or am I thinking of a different movie?
I think you might be thinking of something totally different.
That's the fucking... Yeah, I have no idea what you're talking about.
Well, great. Now I'm going to get killed in Hardline while I Google this shit.
Shit, I've been doing that a lot. I've been getting Brandon Lee the whole night.
Yeah, Beast of the Southern Wild. That's where they got the fucking... Like, they put stuff on pigs.
Oh, man.
And they made them look bigger than they normally would with post-production.
Yeah. I'm about to say, I don't remember giant pigs in that movie.
Remember giant pigs.
Who was that?
I don't remember Flip
be?
Having an accent.
I'm about to say, who was that?
That was, if it was me doing a flip accent, I would have said, I don't remember giant pigs. But I said you, so there you go.
But I didn't say anything about giant.
I'm about to say, I don't.
Well, I said the giant pigs, and you guys were like, I don't know about that. That's a different movie.
No.
Yeah, Flip's the one that said that. You're confusing your lore.
You really
here,
not
sir.
Know how it sounds?
The lore!
He gets us confused like people in Call of Duty do.
It's okay. I just linked a picture of a giant pig, so we're good.
Alright.
We got dudes on the roof sniping, like little bitches.
He's on the what?
Some idiots on the roof just sniping for no reason.
Never mind.
Terrible. Kaiser, you're Netflix shit, yo.
Oh, yeah.
He's fucking playing a video game. We can't talk about that right now.
I guess.
Kaiser multitasking. This is a bad idea.
The only ones I've really heard of were...
He's on a roof playing Hardline.
I'm not in a roof. I'm in a fucking
were
car.
The Idris Elba one and the Pee Wee Herman one.
Yeah, that's the only two I've heard of either. But I guess they're going to start doing theatrical movies and then releasing them at, like, the same time that they stream them. People are like fucking getting pissed off about it. I don't understand whether they're mad, but yeah, that's the only two I'd heard of.
That was the big thing with Cary Fukunaga's.
And the fucking new Pee Wee movie. Because I didn't know they made a fucking another Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon.
Oh, you know what? I did hear about the Adam Sandler one too on account of all the pissed off people.
And I guess like some stupid new fucking. Sandler flick.
Did y'all watch that Cobbler movie?
No.
It was called The Cobbler.
I bet it's fucking terrible.
It was like there was a bunch of shit that was like, yeah, this only an idiot in a movie would think this was. So, yeah, it wasn't that great. I mean, it wasn't terrible, but it wasn't that good either.
It's not old Sandler?
Yeah, it's. There'll never be old Sandler. Hell, even old Sandler's kind of muddied now just from his normal work.
Right.
Even old Sandler, you kind of look back and be like, I guess I like that.
But the Beasts of No Nation movie, that caused all the stir because Netflix bought it because it seems like a great awards contender according to everybody who's seen it.
Right.
And in order to qualify for the Academy Awards, it has to be like debut in theaters.
Yeah,
and since they're debuting it in theaters and streaming at the same time, people are bitching about that, thinking it's not fair or whatever. I mean, I don't understand.
Don't they release fucking review copies for people to watch at home anyway when it's fucking...
Yeah, but they're complaining like it's taking away the sanctity of the theater. Oh my god.
Yeah.
You know, they're used to only shitty movies that will never get an award anyway being released on streaming services same day as theaters. So they're bitching about this supposedly great movie being released both ways.
Because they don't want
fucking, going to cheapen it.
Just because
they don't want Netflix
Idris Elba
to try to fucking
lead.
Win a movie or try to get an Oscar.
It was Channing Tatum. They let that shit happen.
Channing Tatum ain't going to win an Oscar for playing an African general anytime soon.
I don't know if he uses that ancient technique that they used in some of those older movies, like fucking Birth of a Nation, I think he could be convincing.
Gonna go all Al Jolson.
I don't know if that's a reference to that movie. I don't know.
No, it's not. But
Al Jolson.
I think I've even mentioned him before on this
show.
We've
talked about this.
And nobody knew about him then either, except for Kaiser. And we explained it at that point.
Let's do a re-up on that explanation, bro.
Al Jolson was a Jewish fella from the early 1900s who liked to put on blackface and dance.
Oh, okay.
Pretty much.
Fuck that guy. But yeah, I guess that's what I was referring to, something of that nature.
Going about what Jews had to do with black folks back in the old days.
All right.
Not just the old days. I mean, Jewish people have been black as recently as Sammy Davis Jr.
Damn.
I mean, Al Jolson started the trend, but then Sammy Davis kept it alive.
Oh, man.
Dang, nice save, ZP. Nice save.
You're on the roll tonight, boy.
Oh, that's fucking hilarious.
But yeah, I don't know. I guess Netflix is just fucking smashing with their original TV programming.
Yeah, they
repeat with movies. Don't fucking it with talk TV. Again when I talk.
They, I'm agreeing with you. They've been killing it with the TV shit, and now they're
going
to attempt to kill it with the movie shit. Yeah. I think Hollywood is afraid of that.
They're terrified.
They're very afraid. Yeah.
Because if they start winning Oscars alongside fucking Emmys, they're going to be fucking worthless.
Right?
You know, and I still like going to the theater depending on the movie. But
when it's something amazing like Interstellar and you can watch it in IMAX?
I mean, no. I watched Interstellar on a regular screen theater, and it was fine. But I wouldn't call that movie amazing.
What?
I've only watched it one time, so I'm going to watch it again.
Same, I've only
watched. I'm pretty sure it was amazing.
I cannot believe you've only watched it one time. Like, that was your shit.
It was, but I didn't. I never bought it, because I bought something else instead, and I was supposed to buy it. And I just never went around to buy it.
It was one of those movies I can see once and not need to see again anytime soon.
I was about to say, like, you know, the fucking, you know all the tricks of the movie now, you know what I'm saying? Like, but that one time, you know, when I got, you know, the cherry pop, that shit was amazing. But maybe.
Yeah, but yeah, Hollywood's freaking the fuck out.
They should, man. Fuck them. They're the ones sponsoring that TPP
shit. Yeah, they gotta fucking change shit.
They're fucking, like, trying to make, like, copyright shit, like, oh, glass, but. So I make copyright shit worse just so they can control more.
Right.
They're like losing all their shit.
Fuck. Still sniping up there.
I switched classes on that.
The new young Han Solo movie?
Yeah.
What's that about?
Well, it's been announced that there's going to be a new one of those. You know how Star Wars is doing a new numbered sequel?
Fortunately,
every year, every other year, then in the years in between, they're doing new standalone movies, and one of those movies has been announced to be a new Han Solo movie about his years before the first appearance. The guys who did the 21 Jump Street movies and the Lego movie are apparently directing it, and they're looking for the new young Han Solo, and just, yeah, what are your thoughts, fellas?
Like we just said earlier, like, they can't fucking try to nod to the fucking original shit.
If nerds would just quit pretending they're being nerds by liking Star Wars, I'd be okay. You don't have to like Star Wars to be a nerd, guys. I promise you.
Hey, but are you not a Star Wars fan?
Not anymore. I was as a kid, but after other than the Ewoks, fuck Star Wars.
Problem is, I haven't been able to watch the fucking Star Wars, like the original one, since the 90s. Because I can't find the real shit without this stupid, you know, special edition.
Well, they just re-released, I don't know if they released them yet, but they're releasing, like, another version, like, on Blu-ray, to where it's like their original ones without all the fucking bullshit.
Have they announced that? I heard it was coming out on Blu-ray, but I didn't hear that, like, it announced that it would be the actual legit.
Yeah, it's supposed to be like the legit fucking old school original ones before Lucas fucking decided to fuck with shit. Now I'll watch those because fucking, you know, I haven't watched those since I was a kid. But fucking,
I'm okay.
Do a lot of people hate the fucking special edition Star Wars?
For some reason, I don't think they're that much worse than the originals.
They changed a bunch of shit, dude.
Well, see, I get pissed off. I mean, I guess I can't say pissed off, but I
did already.
I get I get frustrated and disappointed by, like, I bought Evil Dead a number of times on DVD and Blu-ray, and because it's always different cuts, and yeah. I get frustrated with Sam Raimi fucking fixing those movies, like the original Evil Dead. He is like the last few editions. He's digitally erased. You know, some fuck ups, which, yeah, I get it. They were fuck ups, but they've been fuck ups for 30 years now.
Yeah, just
and they're part of the movie. He like digitally erased a, I think it was Rob Tappert or somebody who worked on the movie was like standing next to a bridge early on. He wasn't supposed to be there. He's like in the shot. And now, like, everyone's looking for the, everyone who's seen the movie a bunch knows that's there. And then when it's gone, you're like, what the fuck?
Right.
It's one of those things. The director who did the remake of Evil Dead. Some interview with Ari's being cute, and he was watching the original Evil Dead with him while he was interviewing him. And the director of the remake's like, okay, look, coming up here, you're actually going to see. And then he's like, oh, I guess we must have missed it. I didn't see it. He's like, no, you didn't fucking miss it. You're watching a copy that Sam Raimi fucked up.
That's fucking hilarious.
But, yeah, it's, you know, it's been around. It's people know the movies as they are. There's no need to fix them.
Yeah. Just leave them. Just leave them alone. Just...
And if you feel the need to fix them, have the option.
Yeah.
Oh, just include the original cut, yeah. Basically?
Yeah.
Or, yeah, or include the director with the originals.
I mean, there was a period where Lucas was like, the originals don't even exist anymore.
Yeah.
Well, you know.
A, you're fucking lying, and B, shut the fuck up.
Oh, and that's pretty harsh for the father of Star Wars.
If only he
and Indiana Jones.
You know, Indiana Jones was...
Something ZP bought four times.
Was not George Lucas's own little baby.
Well, I mean, I know, but didn't he come up with the original concept, or he met with like
Lawrence
like
Kasdan
Spielberg.
Lawrence Kasdan. Spielberg didn't even write it.
Lucas came up with the story and all that. Just all like right. Lucas had the came up with the story of her fucking Willow. He's like, right. I read the Hobbit books, and now I'm going to make my own Hobbit movie, only without hobbits. And then he made Willow and had somebody else write it, and he had Ron Howard direct it, and it became an amazing movie.
I kind of like Willow.
I fucking love Willow.
Oh, I love Willow.
Willow's amazing. I haven't seen that in a long time, bro, but Val Kilmer and the fucking midget, I can't remember his name.
Warwick Davis. I still say stand aside, Peck, when I walk by short people. It's great.
Oh, I'm a short person, damn.
But yeah... Lucas is an idea man, and then he needs people to, you know, shape his ideas. Yeah.
I mean, you know, everybody has their place in the machine.
But he shouldn't try to fuck him up. Could try to change him.
I mean, I don't think he fucked up Kingdom of the Crystal Skull by himself.
That seemed like he had a bunch of enablers. A gangbang effort.
A lot of people had to fuck that up.
Yeah, that was a spit roast.
That seemed like a fucking surefire win, because I like Shia LaBeouf, and I like fucking, obviously, goddamn Harrison, and, you know.
Do it!
Didn't Kate Blanchett play the fucking villain?
She was the Russian lady.
Yeah, it's like, how can you fail?
That movie, though, fucking, I remember Spielberg, when he was making it, like, leading up to the movie coming out, he was talking about how they wanted to keep it as close to the original as they were going to do. The same kind of stunt work as they did in the original movies. They were going to keep it as minimal CGI as possible. And then it comes out, and it opens with CGI gophers, and there's CGI everywhere, and there's Shia LaBeouf swinging through jungle vines, and the army
of CGI ants.
Yo, that's
real. So what the fuck are you talking about?
Flexing his non-existent muscles.
Do it! Check the nut veins in my neck, boy. I'm Metal Man Randy Savage. Do it! Yeah. I don't care. That dude's like the hero of it. He's the hero of the world right now. I don't give a shit.
I do like that
God.
That actual cannibal shit.
Yeah, that shit was funny.
But
although it had nothing to do with him other than the name.
Well, there's that live rendition on stage that they did with him at the end. Whoop. Have you not seen that?
Whoop-de-doo.
No. Aww. Yeah, who do y'all think should play young Indiana Jones? Not Indiana Jones, fucking Han Solo.
Young
Indiana Jones should be River Phoenix.
Yo, you might as well let young Han Solo might as well just be Chris Pine again.
No. I'm thinking, even though he's damn near 40, I'm thinking Jensen Ackles.
Why would... Yes. I don't why would y'all lead me to some clickbait site? I gotta click through every single fucking picture.
Like, I didn't even click all those. That's why I actually skipped it, because I was too busy playing Hardline.
As long as it's not him right now. Christensen, I'm good. Who the fuck...
They got fucking Jay Courtney. Dude. They got fucking Jay Courtney on that list. Fuck Jay Courtney.
Who is that?
Michael Biehn in the new Terminator movie. Motherfucker looks nothing like Michael Biehn. Has none of the fucking Michael Biehn awesomeness.
Why did they not get Michael Biehn?
So yeah, I'm thinking, get 40-year-old Jensen Ackles to play him.
Oh. That'd be funny.
Well, how young are they talking about making him? Because I like that kid from Jurassic World. I think I don't know how young he really is, but he looks like a fucking, 18-year-old kid. But he was in Boardwalk.
Are you talking about the older brother?
Yeah, exactly. I like that kid. I don't know if...
he didn't suck.
I mean, right. So I think he might be okay. I mean, depending on when they're trying to film it, might grow into that shit.
I think Jensen Ackles are just in station.
Man, come on, bro. He's
can't beat that.
we should get I like Chris Pine and all, but we should get Jensen Ackles to play young Indiana Jones and the young fucking Han Solo.
I like it.
Let's
lobby for this.
Let me see.
He didn't even make the fucking list, but God Eastwood looks too much like his dad to be Harrison Ford.
Liam Hemsworth doesn't look like his brother enough. Anthony Ingruber? How do you pronounce that shit? All right. Never mind. Skip. Theo James? Theo was a Cosby kid.
Let's get Malcolm Jamal Warner.
Yo,
I'm from an Eddie movie. You know I'm secretly hoping that they also have, like, a young fucking Lando.
Oh, they've got to.
Dog, if they have, like, what if it's a fucking, like, the adventures of these motherfuckers with Chewie? Son, that should be better than
movies.
Yeah,
I gotta watch it.
Yeah, dog.
Especially with Malcolm Jamal Warner. Like Anthony and Eddie Griffin
Malcolm
as
Jamal
Wookie.
Warner and Jensen Ackles and Chewbacca.
If Eddie Griffin is the Wookiee and Malcolm Jamal Warner, and they're Malcolm and Eddie again.
Come on, son.
With some little whoever playing Han Solo won't make a shit anymore because it's Malcolm and Eddie.
Cameron Monaghan? No, bro. Ansel Elgort? Damn, can we get an American sounding person?
They don't do shit anymore.
Oh, I have a lot of funny look. Aaron Taylor Johnson, Quicksilver?
That's kick ass.
I know, I can't fuck with that shit. Jay Courtney? But you hate that guy.
I didn't hate him initially, but he was in fucking Die Hard, and then he was in Terminator and several other disappointing things, and just kind of stop for a bit, guy.
Well, it's their fault for casting.
Why do they have this shitty picture of Dylan O'Brien? Whoever this guy is. I'm going to find out who that young kid's name is, and I'm going to throw his hat in the ring.
Jurassic World, bro.
Just get fucking Wendell.
Chris Klein.
Young.
Oh, Lando. Nick Robinson?
Chris Klein.
Come on. Y'all gotta chill.
He's wonderful, Wilford, man.
Y'all gotta chill.
Oh, fuck.
But, Nick Robinson is that kid. So, him. How old is he, though? He's 20.
You can get Nick Robinson for Han and Craig Robinson for Lando.
First off, I'll go see damn near anything Craig Robinson is in. So you got me sold already.
Oh, shit. That's fucking hilarious.
He looks nothing like Billy Dee Williams. But I don't give a shit. Every movie he's ever been in, he's great. So I don't care.
Oh, yeah. He's fucking hilarious.
Yeah. So, damn, dog. Craig Robinson, man. He couldn't be in a Star Wars movie.
He could have his little shiny space cape that Lando had.
Done. He should be like, they should make a Spaceballs sequel and then put him in that.
Fucking Spaceballs.
Fucking Spaceballs.
Yeah, I don't know. I want that kid to play him, but we'll see.
And then Michael B. Jordan as Lando.
Well, I get
bro, I don't know. You know what? Michael B. Jordan is a good... I like him as an actor. He's in a lot of shit.
Who the hell is Michael B. Jordan?
Fucking Wendell.
He's Wallace.
You don't remember He's Apollo Creed's son in the new Creed.
Oh, yeah, he's fucking Creed, yeah.
And that shit looks good.
Yeah, that shit does look good. Okay, I saw the trailer. Yeah, okay.
That shit's gonna be good. I mean, what else is he in?
Because everybody seems to know him, apparently.
He can definitely recreate the Billy Dee Williams mustache, so...
Well, you know what? Wallace and Avon are in Creed.
Oh, shit, Avon's in Creed? I mean, I was gonna see it anyway.
Who is in fucking C, man? I need that motherfucker to pick me up. His car's all fucked up.
We're getting shit on.
Michael B. Jordan's in C.
Oh, your brother's in here, too.
Good for him.
He's probably trying to talk to us.
Ow. No. Funny about that Nick Robinson guy from Jurassic World is, I told one of my brothers after we saw the movie, that, you know, that kid should be the new Spider-Man, and then they cast some British kid.
Yeah, I don't know why they hate America so much. These American franchises.
But... I'm afraid of America. I'm afraid of the world.
What is Tubby saying, bro?
He's singing some David Bowie.
God, destroyed. Fucking destroyed.
Speaking of musicians, Kaiser linked Corey Taylor of Slipknot fame, also that shitty Stone Sour band, talking shit about Kanye. The Kanye.
Yeah.
He shit on Jesus?
Yes, he did.
And it's actually pretty good.
It is pretty good.
You gotta be easy, my dude.
Look at back, I'm at Jesus. Flip, would you like to read the quote?
Jesus came down off of the cross and
produced these beats. Yeah, I'm gonna fucking read that shit. Hold on.
I'm actually pissed. I'll be right back.
Kanye, you are not the greatest living rock star of all time. The fact that you had to tell people that kind of says... Oh, wait. The fact that you had to tell people that kind of says it all. You remind of the guy who brags about pussy. They never get as much as they brag about. Stop it. Slaps wrist. Stop it.
Who is this? Fucking Corey Taylor from fucking Slipknot.
Alright.
Yeah, watch the video though. Watch the fucking... I'll link the YouTube link to the fucking video. Pretty fucking funny.
People watching this over our Battlefield footage, don't watch the video. Keep watching us.
Yeah.
I'm heading to fucking E.
I think that was the entire the bit for that segment.
It was.
I have nothing else to say. Fuck that guy.
Which guy, Kanye?
Definitely not Kanye the God. Fucking Corey Taylor.
Shit.
Kanye the God. He's upgraded. He's not just Jesus. He's the God.
Fucking right he is.
So he's the whole Trinity.
All in one, bro. That's value.
If anybody gets shit on Kanye, then that's anybody, because, yeah. Definitely Corey Taylor would be... He can actually sing, and like we saw Kanye in the Queen video.
I mean, I bet he can't sing fucking like Freddie Mercury, so.
Yeah, if fuck he did, him. He should do a fuck. They should do a fucking Queen cover.
I bet he won't do it.
I got D, though. How about that?
You got D? Fucking good shit, dude. I'm in the
A. Get D tomorrow. We
work out. Talk about you. Here comes a D.
He's gonna fucking try to spot you and then just let it fall on your fucking head.
You're like, you need some help, Tubby. Get it up, boy.
Oh, man.
You got some chop.
Oh, I don't like that shit.
Nah, give me the chop. I'm going in.
Bro, what is wrong with you, man?
I'm getting tired of getting Brandon Lee over here.
Oh no.
You see what you did? You see what you did?
You asked.
Oh shit. That's fucking hilarious.
I've been drinking my vodka and pretty water.
Vodka and pretty water? What flavor? Yeah.
Cherry.
Cherry flavored vodka.
Cause cream.
Yeah, fucking, that's fucking hilarious. I think Kanye and Corey Taylor should get into a fight.
Well, I don't know who would win on that one.
I think Kanye wins probably every fight ever, unless it's a paparazzi.
Yeah, but, I mean, he could just bust his jaw up again. That'd be a bitch for him. He's like, damn it, gotta wire my fucking jaw again. And that's when he did his best shit.
Kanye always like he's holding food in them jaws.
Hungry boy, man.
Jaw. He's like, I'm holding some holding some nuts for this recording session.
All right.
Watch out. Oh,
in
damn,
his
I just got a
pouches,
double.
It's not like man nuts flip. It's okay.
Hey, see, if you, me and your brother are riding the motorcycle, we've been running over everybody in doubles. We can't even talk to each other. He's probably like, Jay, tell me you're doing good. Just tell him I said he's doing good, too.
Is that how he's talking?
No, I told him earlier today that... that if he plays, we won't be talking to him because of what we were doing.
Not because of him being an outcast in your group, or what?
Because he's afraid of America?
No, not because he's an outcast in the group. You know, you don't tell the outcast in the group that they're an outcast in the group. That's why nobody tells me.
Oh.
Oh, shit. I'm going for the main bridge, guys.
We got Ted McGinley on our topics because he's trending right now, I guess.
He is. He is trending.
Not to be confused with John C. McGinley.
What the fuck? He's trending? What the fuck?
No.
Tommy missed the joke.
So I thought we discussed this the other day.
I'm confused totally, so.
We did.
What? Apparently, there's some idiot from some website called Jump the Shark who thinks that... like, Ted McGinley ruined series, and, like, he tried to be like, oh, yeah, as soon as he joined Married with Children, it went off the air, and, like, it's, like almost 11 years later it went off the air.
And keep in mind, that article that Kaiser linked is old as shit in itself.
Yeah, it is. I'm
okay, but did the guy not say that, or did he not say that?
He said it, but...
Wait, so there were no fucking quotes to be had from that shit, or what?
Nothing of worth,
that was, yeah, he was pretty much calling him... like the sitcom killer or some shit where,
but every show
he,
was
he
on
tried
was
to
like...
shit on Jefferson and got fucked up.
Yeah,
and
did.
Yeah, you don't.
Yeah,
shit
Jefferson,
on Jefferson
was way better than Steve.
Yeah, for real. Steve was like, you could tell he just wanted to sing opera the whole fucking show, and then he left the show to go sing opera. And then he like, even when they got together, he's like, I regret leaving the show to go sing opera.
Yeah,
something that blew my mind was they were talking about Happy Days and how he took over as the dude on that. And then it, you know, went off the air. But apparently it lasted four fucking years, 4.5 seasons or whatever with McGinley.
After joined, yeah.
And I had no idea it lasted that long in the first place, let alone 4.5 fucking years after Opie left.
Yeah, for real.
And then 7 for fucking Married with Children.
Was it 7 or was it more?
I think it was 7.
So actually, I think Ted McGinley is actually the original Dwayne Johnson, the franchise Viagra.
Smell when the Ted is cooking.
Whoa.
Marcy. Chicken legs.
And who didn't like Revenge of the Nerds?
Right?
Exactly. Exactly. McGinley all up in that bitch. Oh, all shit. All
right. I thought we were going to do a 7 segue.
I'm jumping around.
Oh.
Would you like
tip
to
up,
host?
Up and get down.
Would you like to host?
ZP's like House of Pain right now. I'm Irish.
Well,
jump up and get down.
What's funny is like we literally jump around in the topics every episode, but now that it looks pretty, Flip's paying attention to the doc. Like,
I mean, I'm just trying to reward your hard work it. With like more focus.
Yeah, for real. You made it all pretty and stuff. We don't want to shit on your work.
Right, I'm just trying to be good, but I'll just shut the fuck up and we can
just lose. I don't see anything spelled R-U-F-F in there, though, so I'm just kidding.
I think that'd be rough.
That's how you spell rough, not rough.
Oh, we ain't going to miss by Tubby, though.
One of those is rough, and one of those is rough.
Only you can find out the difference.
Oh, no, I lost the D.
I mean, if you guys had distinguished hearing such as myself.
You had a Texas sports coat to take.
What the fuck, bruh?
Bradley Cooper.
What's wrong with y'all, man?
We've been drinking and driving cars.
I ain't been drinking. What? I got me some Powerade. That's about it.
You get the last
time. I don't know what your problem is.
Y'all got
I didn't
chill,
think
bro.
I had a problem, but I've got vodka and bitch water. Now you're telling me. Bitch water. Bitch water.
Oh, I got Chase's guy down. He got the D. I want the D.
Yeah, you do. Get all that D. It's so fast.
So I went and saw a fucking movie for free the other night, and there were a bunch of people online because people show up for free shit.
Were they excited about it, though?
I mean, they were so excited, they had their fucking iPhone out, and they put it on their head and did that little trivia game that people like to play.
Why would you put it on your head, though? What does that
because
just...
Because... You're supposed to put the phone with the screen facing out, and I played it with people on an iPad, and the screen's facing out, and that way you don't see it. It's just the whole gimmick, and...
Oh, I got it. I got it.
No, let me get... I'm right behind you. Right behind you. Slow down. Slow down.
Anyways...
Oh, we got the B.
Yes!
They're talking about the movie Seven, and none of, like only one of them had even heard of it. None of them have seen it, and there are a bunch of them, and they're all, you know, 20-something hipster-ish people, and they hadn't fucking even heard of Seven.
Wow.
A good number of them.
Holy
which is
shit.
Baffling to me, because that's a pretty big movie.
And a fucking great movie.
And people love to suck David Fincher's dick, and that's one of the movies they refer to in doing so. Fight Club first, and then that, typically.
I think I like Seven better than Fight Club.
I like Zodiac better than any of them.
Yo, Zodiac is also very dope.
Yeah, Zodiac was good as fuck.
Like the last time Robert Downey Jr. was actually great in something.
What?
Iron Man 1.
What?
Robert Downey Jr. was bad.
Exactly.
I saw The Judge a few months ago, and I actually liked that,
okay.
too.
I was going to say, I've seen The Judge.
I heard that was all right. I don't know, I feel like he's acting like Tony Stark in every movie now.
Motherfucking Tropic Thunder.
I mean, Robert Downey Jr. and Mel Gibson got that going on.
Fucking Air America.
Well, ever since, you know, Downey Jr. did some jail time, he's like, fuck being a liberal, yo.
I'm just glad he didn't fucking OD or fucking Brandon Lee himself.
Yeah, can you imagine that? If he would have, you know, really, really fucked himself over when he was going crazy in the 90s?
Oh, man. I'm so glad he didn't fucking OD.
Kaiser had to stop the motorcycle to think about
that. We'd have Tom Cruise as Iron Man.
Oh, God. Can we please get that motherfucker out of movies? Tired of seeing motherfuckers on stilts.
As a short person, I feel like I should step in here and say something.
You ain't that short, though. I gotta set the squat rack down one bar lower for you. I ain't gotta set it all the way down to the ground so Tom Cruise can slide underneath it and like, worry it up.
Nobody has to know that shit, bro. Nobody has to know. Thanks for fucking my life.
I know, man. We should know that Tom Cruise has to do the caterpillar to get into the squat bar.
Look at me go.
Y'all gotta chill, bro.
I'm just saying, man, if you were drunk driving a motorcycle in the swamps, you understand.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what I have to do.
I'm gonna come right out and say that I actually enjoy Tom Cruise's movies for the most part.
I was about to say I like Tom Cruise, but you know. Since he jumped on that couch, he's been.
I don't get the legend hype, but I've liked all the Mission Impossibles, you know, to one extent, one way or the other. And Jack Reacher was pretty damn great.
Jack Reacher was pretty good.
Jack Reacher. I like him in Collateral. I like him in Collateral. Like almost everything he's done.
I like
he's not
Edge
a bad
Tomorrow.
Actor. I just hate when they put him in badass roles, knowing that, like, Bruce Lee could even shit on him.
Right.
You got something against short people?
Right.
That are badasses? Yes.
I'm coming up right behind you, Toby.
B says it needs to be the same thing because he knows it's true. He's like 6'4".
He was like,
I feel the same way.
He's my favorite samurai of all time. Oh, so.
Yeah, The Last Samurai was actually, you know, as much as it's maligned because, you know, white guy's Last Samurai.
I feel like it was maligned? I don't know. I mean,
in the circles I ran.
Everyone loved it when it came out, but
ever since, even though that
politically conscious people like to shit on it. Yeah,
I thought it was based on like a true story or some shit.
No, I don't think it's been a true story, but it was a good movie. I watched it.
I feel like white people helped.
I liked it.
Some Japanese armies at some point. I don't fucking know. I don't even.
We did. We helped. We helped end centuries of tradition, and I'm proud of that.
We have to end the feudal system and give them guns instead of swords. Because Chuck Al.
I don't think you have to pronounce the W.
Yeah, if you're a Pain fan, you do.
I know how he says it in the fucking song.
Don't get all touching now, Zimpy.
I don't
personally
understand.
Personally, I like.
Nobody cared when Bob died. Nobody cared to try and save him.
A fan of One-Legged Girl.
Oh, One-Legged Girl. I could win the One-Legged Girl.
I don't. What?
Wait till my vocal covers come, baby.
The fuck are y'all talking? Guys.
He's got blue-gray eyes.
Yeah.
I don't like this.
Maybe
shit
that's where my amputee fetish started.
For our Weeaboo fans, he wants to be like Guy King.
Or maybe a Viking. Then he can win the
Strong
One-Legged
as
Girl.
The Thing.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. But then I can win the One-Legged Girl.
He was as cool as Ash in Army of Darkness.
Yeah.
Fucking have that chick.
These people are like zoning out. I'm like, just wait, just wait. Ah, you can't hit me with that rocket launcher, bitch. I'm on a motorcycle.
Oh, motorcycle.
Are you still on the bike?
No, I lost it. He hit me.
Oh, no.
Server didn't say it was so until it was too late.
Hey, guys.
What's up?
Do you have more topics, or do you want to go to listener questions?
Now we talked about True Detective, and...
We can talk real quick about... DP might be the only person that even knows that this is happening, but... Or not. Marissa Tomei is
going to be
the new fucking Aunt May, right?
What?
Yes,
is she going to share her titties?
I don't think we need to see them.
Didn't she do them in that movie, The Wrestler, and they were terrible?
They were wonderful in The Wrestler. I don't know what you're talking about.
They were not terrible.
And
just
The Devil Knows You're Dead.
Yep. Yeah.
When fucking Flip
that movie I haven't seen, but I have definitely seen those images from that movie.
That's a good fucking movie.
It's a pretty good movie.
I'll just always remember as My Cousin Vinny.
She was hot in that, too.
She's not ever been
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'll remember her as. That's when she was hot.
She's still hot.
Still very smashable, bro.
She was in that Duplass movie, Cyrus, which that's probably my least favorite movie by them, but she was great in that.
Okay, calm down, Tomei fan.
Spawn on me. Spawn on me, Toby.
I'm just saying I'd be happy to visit with Aunt May.
Okay, hold on.
I agree.
See D coming up on me. I'm going to catch the D.
Yeah, you will. You know you will, you dirty girl.
Why you stop driving? There's a guy up here now.
Go, man.
Oh, I couldn't hit
Fire it. Emblem is really good.
All right, I am on the D.
Now bounce.
Hit all the bumps.
Bounce on it.
Come on. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Bounce on that. Well, he's on a motorcycle. He's on a motorcycle, Flip. So he's going to bounce on it. Up and down. And it's D, so he's going to bounce on the D.
Alright.
I'm not lying. I'm not
which
lying.
Which one of you is Kanye and which one is Kim?
Oh, God.
Why can't I be Ray Kim? J and Kim?
You,
what the fuck?
Because you're on a motorcycle.
I'm about to say, you know Kaiser is going to be Kim in this fucking really. I think everybody knows that.
Oh, shit.
Internet high five. Oh, damn.
You can be Ray J, Toby.
Okay, I'll be Ray J.
Can you imagine in about 10 years when they reboot Spider-Man again and Kim is Aunt May?
Kim's going to be Aunt May. She'll still look the same because of plastic. Kim Kardashian's fine as fuck. I don't even care.
Yeah, right. So I was like, I ain't got nothing against it.
Yeah, like fucking, I don't care what weird science went into making her. I'll knock
them down. I'll watch her take it any which way she wants to take it.
Yep.
Can't believe we're at 300 grand all tonight.
What?
You've already made 300 grand?
Can't believe I'm only at 300 grand all
tonight. Oh, shit. I'm at 335.
Alright, so we're going to head on to listener questions?
Yeah, we can go to listener questions.
Because I got something special for y'all during listener questions.
Oh, really? I'll start with the ones from the forums. I've gathered into our beautiful Google document.
What's what forums from where?
The digitalconfederacy.com forums.
Oh, okay.
They can be found on the internet digitalconfederacy.com/forums.
Excellent. Excellent.
Sounds like a terrible place to be.
It's pretty neat. John Delocated. John Delocated says, for ZP, would you rather banging your favorite porn star or getting immortalized into the new Fable as a main character? Now, I'd be hard-pressed to name a favorite porn star, but I would go with that one. Because, you know, the best part about Fable is creating your own character. The new game has these predetermined ones. So it won't live up to the Fable 2 levels of greatness or the Fable 1, but...
this motherfucker spent 3 weeks thinking about this.
Not at all. It's a very easy call.
Pro cons list and like Google Flash should love me not.
It's a very easy call for me. So there's my answer. the banging the porn star one. Because, you know, in Fable, you're supposed to have your character evolve with you as you go through the story. Wonderful. The second question from John Delocated is for Blasto. I don't know why he thinks Blasto is on the show.
But he listens.
For Blasto, really? Gin and metal equals good, but not PlayStation? And there's two question marks because he's dead fucking serious about this.
Blasto loves the PS2, don't worry.
Okay, is that your official answer? Because you're speaking for Blasto?
I'm speaking for Blasto. PlayStation 4 is the best console this generation.
Ew.
Blasto will back me up on this.
I'm seriously liking my X-Bone.
But I'm PlayStation right now, 4. So what I'm saying
Got you.
PlayStation 4 is the best console this generation right now.
Be saying something disparaging about Kaiser if you're Blasto?
Now that shit writes itself.
Oh, guys.
All right, now question 3 from John Delocated. Now that you guys got me hooked on terriers, how much ransom cash...
You skipped the question?
No, they always skip around. No, let's keep
it. I'm going right through.
Question.
Yeah, I'm fuck off and just pay attention to what's going on around you. So John's third question. Now you guys got me hooked on terriers, how much random cash, I mean Kickstarter money, do you think it would take to get the series re-pickupified?
Probably doesn't even matter, dude. They probably didn't forgot about that shit, unfortunately.
Yeah, I don't think any amount of cash... I mean, aside from some magic benefactor giving $1 billion to somebody is going to get them to write more episodes and get it aired somewhere.
Which is sad, because that show was really fun.
Flip and Kaiser, have you guys watched Terriers?
I have not seen Terriers.
No, sir.
I'm not sure if it's still on Netflix or not, but it's great.
Yeah, you know when I made that joke caption on the front page, if y'all read it, where I put the guys from Terriers as the real true detectives?
Uh-huh.
There was a reason for that. I mean, it was a joke, but it was also because they were fucking great as detectives as well. It was a great fucking show. You can burn through the whole season like in a day, easily.
In a day? How many episodes was it?
It was on FX, so it was only like 10 or 12.
Yeah.
It was just that one season, and they canceled it, right?
Yeah, it only made one.
Yeah, I don't know why they would cancel that shit, but yeah, they canceled it.
Fucking Donald Logue's fucking... I love Donald Logue.
Yeah, he's everywhere. It's funny. He's been like, what, Sons of Anarchy? What else did I see? Mm-hmm. He was in fucking... Was he in Justified as well?
I don't know about that.
Was it Supernatural? I saw him like... I was watching a bunch of shows one time. I saw him every fucking where, and I was like...
But yeah,
I was watching Grounded for Life as well.
He Grounded for Life, yeah.
He was in like the Blade movies.
He was in the first one. He wasn't in any of the other ones, though, right?
Probably not. For some reason, I always think he played two different characters in two different ones of those, but I could be completely wrong. But yeah, he's been in a lot of shit, and like his partner in that, great. It's a wonderful show.
Yeah. Speaking of playing two different characters, isn't it funny how the guy from Raising Arizona plays two completely different people in Deadwood?
Oh, Raising Arizona, Raising Hope?
Raising Hope, yeah. Yeah,
yeah, Garrett Dillahunt, that guy's fucking great. He's part of the reason I watched that disappointing Sean William Scott, Courtney Cox movie.
Oh yeah,
dude, he is fucking amazing. And like, he when I saw him appear in fucking Justified, I was like, I know this guy. I don't know where he's from, but like, I know his face. And but like, he was still like, he's such a character actor, dude. It's great.
Yeah,
how good he is.
He can play that serious shit, but like when he goes goofy, he's fucking hilarious.
He's so good as Goofy.
Yeah,
dude.
He really is.
He's the one that shot fucking Bill Hitchcock.
Oh my god, he dies?
Oh yeah.
No, spoiler shit, I didn't know he would
die. You didn't know your
die.
History?
Wild Bill Wild Bill Hitchcock, not Hitchcock, you son of a bitch.
Yeah, and then he comes back as the rich dude.
Oh, nice.
It's funny, I had to look it up, I was like, is he playing, like, is he in this show again? Playing somebody different?
Are they trolling me right now? That's funny.
So yeah. Terriers is never coming back, even though it like should have never left. Because now that Justified's gone, what does FX have?
Nothing.
That I would want to watch as far as dramas go. Like, I don't give two shits about that Tyrant show. Couldn't get into The Bridge. I don't know what else they have. I've never watched The Americans because it doesn't look like anything I care to watch. As far as dramas go,
any of this shit, but it sounds terrible.
What's funny is that so many of those I've watched like a few episodes and then fucking never finished watching it. Like, fucking, The fucking Bridge, I watched, like, the first 2-3 episodes of that, and I was like, alright, this is fucking retarded. And then, what was the other one?
Tyrant and The Americans.
The Americans, I watched a few episodes of that, and I was just like, alright, this is, I can't watch this anymore.
Really? I heard that was great, actually, and I should definitely be watching it, but I haven't seen it.
I was like, I'd really be doing other shit right now.
Yeah. Now from EP... to satisfy Table's lust for having this question asked. If you had to suck the cock of another member of the SJ5, who would it be? No self-sucking allowed. Which one would let fuck you in the booty zone? I think you spelled it butty zone, so I guess it's butty zone.
Butty
zone is very important.
All right, I'm going to answer first. I'm going to go ahead and pick Kaiser because... before he even gets out of his pants, because it never gets touched, he's going to nut. So I ain't got to do shit.
Yeah.
Man, what the fuck, dog? I ain't answering this fucking shit. What's wrong with y'all, man? What's wrong with the people that listen to this shit?
If you see, this is why we don't get questions, because you refuse to answer. You've got to answer it, Flip.
I don't think it has anything to do with my refusal to answer, though. The fuck out of here. No.
Oh, come on, Flip. It's what the listeners want.
All right, Kaiser, what's your answer?
I was about to say, I'd never suck any of y'all's cocks, ever. I'll just I'll just die. Or somebody will just die.
I'm definitely not Flip.
Brendan Lee will die, because I won't suck cock.
There you go. Sometimes it has to happen, bro.
If you could save Brennan Lee's life or bring him back? All you gotta do is suck a dick, Flip. All you gotta do is suck a dick.
R.I.P. to that dude, dog.
Nah, man, the Crow 2 would've been so much better.
Who knows what he's gonna look like now?
I'll be like, nah, Crow 2.
Come on, man.
Just imagine, Brennan Lee could've been in The Expendables.
He could've.
He was expendable for real.
It's a good thing he died, I guess.
He could also been fucking, I don't know, any other fucking, he could have been Iron Man.
Maybe Iron Fist.
Could he be the most beautiful?
So Kaiser, you don't have an answer?
You know about that prince.
Let's see, we'll go with...
I mean, I got pearls and stuff as my...
I don't know, let's see. Well, I know ZP is... if he is truly Jewish, then he'll be circumcised. Right. So that'll be easier.
Oh man,
I'm circumcised. That's just because like that was American tradition up until recently.
So let's see.
And if you're a neo-Nazi table circumcised, I mean shit.
whoa, what?
He's like, no, I'm
what
not.
The fuck, bro?
I'm just.
I'm saying
car.
They don't cut your dick.
All well, right. Yeah, they did that without my permission.
So, no.
You didn't sign the waiver?
Yeah, man.
What's wrong with y'all, man?
At least I didn't get the full sucking head rabbi shit.
Y'all can't drink no more and be on the show.
No, it's not the drinking more, it's the playing the video while we're doing it.
Alright, so Kaiser,
I'll go with DCP, and then you, me, and Toby will make like a little chain. We'll make a little chain.
Well, no, because you can't pick for me. I ain't sucking Toby off.
No, you got to complete the circle.
The goal is going to work.
You got to complete the circle. I'll pick,
you know, I'm going to pick my member of the SJ5. I'm going to pick Skip Thompson.
Oh, hey, baby.
Are you trying to say she has a dick?
She got a dick.
I'm trying to say that's the best option.
No, you gotta go to fucking Tubby because you gotta complete the circle. Because Flip's not gonna complete the circle.
Let the circle remain broken.
Nah, that chain's broke, bro.
Nope, sorry. You have no choice.
ZP is more of a bitch than Flip right now. What the hell?
I'm a bitch because I don't want to fucking.
Cable's trying to guilt me into sucking his cock.
I ain't gonna man up and suck no bitch.
Oh, and the sad thing is, if I did suck Sable Scott, he'd be one of those people, like, exaggeratedly, you know, being all excited and shit.
Oh, man.
Oh, yeah, my life has changed.
You sound like a doggy with three fingers in right now.
Y'all gotta chill out, though. Y'all gotta fucking chill out.
Are we skipping the buddy zone question?
Yeah, that shit's over as far as I'm concerned, bro.
I'm just driving my motorcycle like another.
Alright, so EP's second question, and that stands for, like, Exec Phantasmagoria, for those of you playing at home. To the honkies, in the spirit of that, what would your I Got Turned Black name be? And to Flip, what would your I Got Turned Asian name be?
Bro, what?
If you got turned into an Asian fella, what would your name be? Brandon Lee doesn't count because he was only half Asian.
Bruce Lee.
Nope.
All right. So for now, for the honkies,
I'll go. My name be Pootney Swole. I've thought
Sinclair.
About this.
Mine be Sinclair.
I would be Levi Stubbs.
Oh, you boys didn't put a lot of thought into this.
Years and years of training have led me to this moment. Or I have chosen Pootney Swole.
So we got Pootney Swole, Sinclair, which just makes me think of the movie the show Dinosaurs, Bruce Lee, and Levi Stubbs.
And we'll start a blues band called Hot Butter.
What the fuck?
Alright. A question now from Digtastic.
Oh, okay.
A past guest?
The first part isn't a question, but I'm going to read it anyway.
Alright, you guys need to check chat with us goes on, okay?
Sake of it. I can do the chocolate blackface. You guys should have much racially diverse topics to discuss coming up. Then his question is, other than cream pies, what's your favorite thing to eat? Hey, at least I posted a question.
All right, now check our SJ5 chat. That's all his.
Right. Show enough good chicken.
Oh, sounds like something I shouldn't check.
Check it, man.
It's safe. I don't think you'll be triggered.
Yeah, he says this is
It's not
flippant.
That problematic.
Why is there a big black boar on the top?
That's Beast of the Southern Wild.
That's all ZP right there. Don't
and they
dig on that.
Enough good chicken.
Don't well, blame dig on that one.
Oh, fucking David's in here too.
All these people won't play tonight when we're not talking.
Right.
And they'll never play again.
Yeah, we can't coordinate any team stuff and all this other shit, but hey, let's play.
So, fellas, other than cream pies, what's your favorite thing to eat? I'm going to say chicken burritos.
Fucking Mexican food, yeah.
I'm going to say sushi.
What was the question?
Other than cream pies.
Yeah.
Even though cream pies are not a thing that I've ever eaten, but.
Oh.
You said.
Let me introduce you. We'll call it a post-workout shake.
Plenty I'm of totally protein. Totally good on that.
Plenty bruh. Of protein.
And that's why you need to leave the chain broken so that he can have a open oh. hole to.
to get straight to the tap.
My dude.
A cream pie is when a man loves a woman. And he loves her so much that he doesn't pull out. And then you get to go in afterwards and lick on what he didn't pull out.
Possibly with a straw or a spoon, like a milkshake.
Yeah, you can do it. I want that. She's a freak. But if she ain't a freak, you just got to suck out.
Come on, bro. Oh, my God.
Now, Table's being awful narrow-minded. It doesn't have to be a woman. But if that would make you more comfortable, it can be just guys.
Oh, okay, well. What the fuck is wrong with y'all, man?
No, well, I didn't even get to answer the question. What was the answer question? I got two stuck in
three.
What's
your favorite thing to eat?
I told you five times.
Fucking deaf motherfucker.
I didn't get to answer. This is bullshit.
Can you repeat that before?
He's busy
answer?
Trying to fucking hit on Flip. I didn't get to answer.
And I'm stealing cars, okay?
Oh, my fucking Chris, a boy.
What's your favorite thing to eat other than cream pies? Is that what it was?
For the love of fucking all that's holy, yes.
Okay, sushi.
Damn, sushi two sushis, good. Two Mexicans.
Oh, yeah.
Who the fuck picked Mexican? You're fucking terrible at life.
I like chicken burritos.
I like fucking Mexican. I like fucking
chicken related Mexican products.
I like my tortilla and my cheese with the rotel.
Mexican food is delicious.
Get some peppers.
Oh, it's good, but your favorite? Really? Jesus Christ.
I mean,
I guess I should just say Japanese food because not just sushi.
Right?
I'll eat everything.
Yeah,
I like sushi. I like fucking pho.
Nah.
I like Thai food. I like sushi, but I pick Mexican.
I like them both, motherfucker. I'm fat. Shit.
I like pepperoni pizza.
I like multiple fucking foods. Mexican. I have different genres, motherfucker. I'm sorry.
Different genres. He like classifies his food. Like
he was officially offended that people would pick Mexican food. He's just...
over shit like sushi and stuff. Yes,
we can't all live in Texas, land of the Tex-Mex.
That shit is good too.
Yeah, fucking.
Yeah, okay. I mean Mexican food ain't the shit out. I ain't saying it's terrible. I'm just saying your favorite. Damn, over barbecue, fucking country cooking, fucking. I mean everything.
You're gonna be sucking heads off of crawdads right now. You talking about Mexican food, motherfucker?
Even yeah, exactly. Crawfish, a whole fucking plate of crawfish. You gonna pick Mexican food over there? I'm gonna pick some pico de gallo over sucking heads.
I like fucking pico de gallo, motherfucker. I'm sorry.
I like
I'm sorry,
my too.
Fucking.
Speaking of, let's talk about some Mexican real quick. All right, there's a little bumfuck small town I came from in Louisiana, up north Louisiana. My dad always goes back there and talks about this Mexican place called Chavo's. So good, it's got the best carnitas in the world. He's been all over like fucking El Salvador, Mexico, and shit. So I'm like, okay, I go there, I'll try it. Apparently, carnitas,
pork,
it's just fucking. What you do with a crock pot.
Yeah.
With fucking pork. And these motherfuckers, all they did to flavor it was add a whole bunch of fucking salt. And I'm like, motherfucker, I cooked this shit in a crock pot all day, and I put barbecue and I shred it with a fork, and it shits on your fucking shit. I had to mix pico de gallo and guacamole, which I hate both of, by the way, just to get flavor into this motherfucker.
Carnitas is good, though, bro.
I like barbacoa too.
I fucking
linguine.
It's just Chipotle. Crock pot fucking pork. What do they call it?
Carne asada.
Yeah, I'm good with chicken over any of that.
Dang. It is literally just crock pot fucking pork.
Saying, but you know, wrapped in a burrito.
Oh, they serve pico de gallo.
Or wrapped in a tortilla.
It was fucking terrible. Some like, really? This shit is what you fucking nut over? Jesus Christ.
Get me some empanadas.
You guys roll this up to a sushi roll?
It's just like, wife will put, like, before she goes to work, she'll throw a fucking big old pork butt in the fucking crock pot with some Dr. Pepper and, like, let it fucking cook all day. We'll come home, fucking shred that shit with a fork and barbecue sauce and takes a million times better than that fucking shit they put on a plate and charge you money for.
No David, why did you take this? You fucked this car up last time.
I just saw a seagull. What the fuck?
Well.
This fucker went flying.
Any other questions? Tubby, you said you had a fucking, like, a surprise one?
No, that was Diggs.
That was a picture of a dirty window that says, "Show enough, good chicken." That's not exactly a question.
Chicken good.
I just wanted to recall the night.
Wait, what about show enough chicken?
Apparently it's good.
Yeah. Show enough.
Apparently drives across town.
Chicken done right is pretty tasty. I mean, you have to have a fucking...
Speaking of chicken done right, man, I'm...
fetch it goddamn name.
Flip, you live around the same area I do. What the fuck happened to KFC? Why is there no KFC anywhere around this motherfucker?
Popeyes took it so, dog. I don't know why they got
KFC. Oh, they did that down in Texas, too?
Do they have churches?
Yeah, they have churches, but...
Yeah, I don't give a fuck about nothing but KFC.
I'm about to say, churches is just good for their biscuits. Their chicken is a distant third to the big two.
To fucking Popeyes, yeah.
About a year or so ago, almost all of the KFCs in the Twin Cities up in this whole area in Minnesota got bought out by Popeyes, all the franchises, and like you've got to go pretty far to get to a KFC now. So I didn't know that was like happening all over the place. It's an epidemic.
That's crazy. Please. Yeah, it's fucking terrible, dude. Like I have to probably drive like at least 10 miles to get fucking KFC now. That shit ain't happening.
Yeah, KFC is not close by no more, and it's saddening. But
yeah, for real, dude, what the fuck?
They turn it into
a Firehouse Subs. I mean, which Firehouse Subs is good.
Firehouse Subs is all right.
Yeah, Firehouse Subs is good as fuck. I ain't lying, but I mean, just when I want a bucket of fucking chicken, I'm pretty pissed that I can't get a bucket of fucking chicken. I have to resort to Kroger and Walmart brands.
Oh, God, chill out, bro. You can just make your own fucking chicken.
Right.
I'm thinking about it, man. I got the skillets for it. I'm thinking about just learning some home-cooked fried chicken.
Dude.
Okay, wait, Tommy.
On this episode, Tommy sticks his hand in oil.
Hey, shut up. Shit. You know, it's funny. I was actually doing a presentation the other day, like when I was real busy those other weeks, and... Yeah, I had actually burnt myself cooking, and I sold a lot of policies on that alone.
You know, we could get, like, some crazy hits if you, Brandon, lead yourself while you're, like, deep frying a turkey.
Self first, motherfucker. That sounded like a threat to me, ZP.
I'm just thinking what's best for the Digital Confederacy YouTube channel. And
like you know about the YouTube.
I mean, I know how to edit together, like, music video improvements.
God damn it. That shit was fucking terrible. Oh my God. I actually, like, kept skipping forward, like, please tell me it changes. Of course it doesn't change. Of course it doesn't change. The whole fucking time.
No, it fades to black at the very end.
that
was a classy touch on my part.
There is an ending. Woo! Oh, yeah, that's... Fuck, and then like Nag's always like, you know, like, oh, she's good, blah blah. Like, yeah, by herself, she's fucking pretty A-OK. But stay the fuck out of Ed and Money shit.
On that note, stay the fuck out of Eddie Money's shit.
Kind of hungry for chicken now. Thanks a lot.
Oh shit,
dude, man, you ain't lying, man. I want some KFC, but Lord knows we ain't getting that.
No.
Not anymore.
KFC to be had.
KFC, please sponsor us.
God, that would be even better than
Flesh. And send us free chicken.
Yeah, give me a bucket of original recipes, and I'll suck the
fruit. Yo, I like Popeye's chicken better, but I like the grilled chicken from KFC. That shit is bomb.
Can't do Popeye's, man. I like the Popeye's. They've got too many people sick, man.
What's funny is, they got them sick.
Yeah, like everybody I've ever known that's eaten from the Popeye's where across from where I used to live has gotten fucking sick.
That is literally, maybe it's just, you know, white people's
ever constitution. Ever since I've been here since 2000, since 2000, like, every village I worked at, every time someone went to Popeyes in that area, and I lived across from it eventually.
I'm about to say, that Popeyes has never made me sick, so now you can't say that anymore.
Okay.
For the longest time, we only had one Popeyes up here in the area, And, like, every year there'd be this big national, like, coupon day where you get free whatever the fuck. And, like, every year this Popeye, since it's, you know, participation varies, they never participated. And every year it'd be on the news, all these people fucking rioting and protesting at the Popeyes because they weren't giving them their free shit. And it was, like, every fucking year. And now there's all these Popeyes so people can get their free shit, and it solved all the world's problems.
Why would you not participate? What kind of fuck up you gotta be, like?
Because they're the only game in town. And these people who wanted Popeyes, like, yeah, they'd be pissed off people, but some would show up, not get the deal, and then just still buy something anyway. It's a racket.
The chicken
racket. Now I really want some fucking fried chicken.
Yeah, I'm about to eat something.
I'm trying to throw a hook off to see all this shit.
You wouldn't be able to do that if you're eating chicken.
Right. Oh, I'm abandoning this shit as soon as I get close to a car.
One of those harmonica holders, but put a piece of chicken there, and then you'll be set. You know, talk about, like, the harmonica things you, like, put around your neck and shit.
Oh, we know. It just wasn't fun. No, I would do that, too. If it was KFC right now, I would fucking do that.
Well, no, I'm glad. At this point, I'm glad you have no KFC, so fuck you. I got a KFC right down the street from me, so I'm gonna fucking buy it, take a picture, and fucking...
You would,
eat
too.
It.
You
eat
would
it,
do
fucker.
You're the one that sends me, like fucking pretty-ass pics of your bud, and like, I got Debbie. Terrible. Why are flippin' ZP's
so quiet? I don't know.
Why? I was letting you talk about getting pictures of Kaiser's butt and eating greasy foods.
I'm over here looking at pictures on Instagram, and half of them are of foods. And
that looks good. That bad. Looks good. That looks good.
Yeah, right.
Got one hand on your drumstick while you're doing that?
You know what's the worst thing about tonight? I think we have lost the most in any night we've ever fucking played.
Yeah.
Everybody's going to watch this podcast and be like, these guys suck at hard.
I am not paying attention at all to the game. I'm wandering around. I'm hopping in cars, but I'm really not doing anything.
I feel like I need to show my, like, kill-death and win-loss ratio, like, on the fucking screen so people be like, I'm not throwing me this bad.
At least the good thing is we've always been on top. So.
Right?
Usually when I'm playing this game, I'm driving around and scoring points, but not tonight.
Right? It's like, we're just so bad right now.
My responsibilities as host of the program for the evening come first, because I am dedicated.
There you go. You redid the entire document? I mean... Real life,
dog. I take this shit seriously. As long as we don't have an outside guest, I'm there for you. If we have an outside guest, I don't want to talk to him.
What about your hosting ability?
Why can I not say host?
I don't think that you have a problem saying host at all. I don't.
Yeah, they're trying to add extra inflection. It makes a host. It's not host. It's not a house on the couch.
To add extra inflection.
I mean, I admit I say rough the way I say rough, but my hosting capabilities are just fine.
I fucking hear it. I can hear it.
You hear it?
I can hear it in my ear spaces.
Don't be mad, baby. You still love
yo.
It.
Just accept
it. Dear spaces.
Oh, Lord. CP. An RPG.
Never change.
Oh, shit. That's fucking hilarious.
Could we wrap up the actual podcast part of the podcast?
Perhaps.
Podcast part?
Would anyone like to say goodbye to our dear listeners?
All five of you. I love you.
Yeah.
Don't ever ask no fucking questions about sucking dicks again.
I'd like to apologize on behalf of Flip for not sucking anybody's dick.
Yeah, for real, man. People came expecting some shit tonight, and they didn't get
they off. Didn't get their dick sucked? I'm sorry, guys, but I'm not.
I mean, just think about it. Blazing going down. Well,
nah, bro. I wasn't thinking about it at all.
Now you are.
I'm really not.
You're going to have dreams about it tonight.
I'm still playing Fire Emblem, bro.
Out of my dream. Into my car.
What is he even doing right now?
Dang. Oh, I just got ran over.
He's probably going to drive into the fucking ocean again.
Billy Ocean. The what?
Get out of my dream.
All right, so did we wrap the pod officially or what?
No. Good night, fair listeners. We will talk at you again next
time.
Well,
he's called our listeners white. Good job, ZP.
I didn't mean fair skinned.
No, I didn't mean it to say it, but it just came out.
I mean, it's probably an accurate assessment. I'm just.
What do you mean by that?
You know, I'm gonna drive through Fifth Ward one day and be like, "Bumping like now, coming to you live."
Yeah, we could have some, you know, swarthy Italians listening. I mean,
doesn't have to what? Be Italians. What the fuck did you just say?
The word
swarthy.
Ah, oh, man. SWARTHY. Like, dictionary yourself.
I mean, please don't ever say that word again.
Why not?
Terrible.
You're trying to limit my vocabulary, my lexicon, because...
Apparently somebody in elementary school didn't.
It makes you feel bad.
You illiterate son of a bitch and step up your vocab.
I mean, don't get, you know, Big C on him.
Huh? All right, man. Well,
yeah, I think the show's over.
Yeah, that's a wrap. y'all are gonna still record because of the game?
Nah, I'm gonna stop the game recording too.
Oh.
Well, was it one more like moments of silence? Here's a moment of silence for our Tumblr fans.
Exactly. All right. Well, good night, everybody.
Good night.
Buddy disconnected from your channel.
Ooh, recording. Disconnected? Oh. Shit.
Disconnected? Jesus Christ.
Just straight gone.
Wow, I was going to stop recording. I didn't think about disconnecting. That sucking dick got to somebody.
User in your channel stopped recording.